Hello everyone, welcome back to Garden Fever. Today I got a special episode for you. Today we're going to be talking to you about the capsicum inuum, which for those of you who don't know the scientific name, that's the hot pepper plant or the pepper plant. That's one of my favorites to grow and one of the most favorites in the world to grow too. It's not the top vegetable to grow in gardens in the world, but it is one of the top three, and that's the pepper, the bell pepper, the hot pepper. They range from sweet all the way to extremely hot. And if you're like me, you really love growing peppers. I love peppers. These are Maxibels right here that you can see. You got some habaneros under here. But we'll get you some closer shots of all the pepper plants. But today I'm going to go over how to grow them, some of the basic information on what you need to grow them. They're real easy. They add a lot of flavor and a lot of taste to a lot of things. In fact, the next video I'm going to do is I'm going to make some habanero jelly. I love making ghost pepper and habanero jelly, so the next video is going to be going over that process. But for now, I just wanted to introduce to you one of my favorite plants to grow. And it's one of my favorite. A lot of times I'll be somewhat biased in the medicinal uses, the flavoring uses, on the how easy they grow kind of determines my desire to grow them. But I love peppers because they're simply so many uses. I use them a lot. I put them in jellies. I love them in tacos. I love them in salads. I love them in hash browns. I can go on and on. Omelets. I love bell peppers, and I love sweet peppers, and I love hot peppers. It's one of those things, one of those plants where either you love them or you hate them. There's not a whole lot of in between. But and most people like the flavor but can't handle the heat. But those like me that can handle the heat, there is no flavor like it. So with that, I'll break away and start getting into the information. I encourage everybody to grow bell peppers. Not only for the flavoring, like I said, in the taste, but there is some actual nutrient value. They have a lot of vitamins. They also have some medicinal uses, which we'll go over throughout the video. All right, pepper plants are members of the nightshade family, and they are grown in zones 5 to 12 typically. However, that can vary a little bit due to microclimate, so that's just kind of the general one. Generally grown as annuals. Native to Central and South America, and even some parts of North America, they have been noted to be found. So they require full sun. They want 60 and above temperatures. I usually prefer 70 to 80. I think that's the best range. So they're a warm weather vegetable, and they prefer soils between 7.0 to 8.5. Loose and loamy, even sandy to a point. They like it real loose, real compacted soil makes for smaller peppers, basically. They just don't do as well in clay. So Utah has hard clay soil, so for anybody growing in hard clay soil, that's a tip for you, is to loosen it up, get it as loose as possible, and they'll do better. Pepper plants range from sweet to very neutral type things like bell pepper. They're not spicy at all, to even sweet to extremely hot. The Carolina Reaper is considered to be the hottest pepper at this point, with the scorpion pepper and the ghost pepper being close contenders. They range from orange, red, yellow type colors. Green peppers they're usually picked when they're not perfectly ripe, a little bit before, and then as they are picked, they turn red or yellow or orange, and then that's an indicator that they're more ripe as they get more redder and change colors. The redder they are, the harder they go. So if you want them still kind of spicy but on the milder side, it's a good idea to pick them when they're green and kind of eat them when they're green. If you want them super, super hot, pick them when they're red like that. Those things are some hot peppers right there. And these are the scorpion peppers that you're looking at. But they have a lot of nutrients. They have vitamin C, A, B, B6, E, K1. They're very good with antioxidants. They have potassium and copper as far as minerals. So there's some nutrient value. They have some medicinal uses, like some gastric relief, can help with sinus infections. One of the great things about peppers, and one of the best tips that I have for you, is that it can ramp up your metabolism, which can help for burning fat and weight loss. So I think weight loss is a good one for peppers. These are habanero peppers. I don't know if you can see them very well, but these ones are orange ones, and these are very hot too. Habanero is usually about as hot as I go. The rest, I grow a hotter peppers for novelty reasons and for pest control. What I mean by that is if you dry it up and put it into a powder and put it on your topsoil, it can help with resisting bugs. I find peppers to be an extremely great, because it contains capsicums or capsaicins. Probably said that wrong, but it's what makes it hot. And it's in an oil, it's like an oil type solution that it rubs off, so it doesn't just wash off, it becomes like an oily type solution. So you can put it in a spray bottle and use it to spray your plants to resist bug infestation. It's hot, and that's what it boils down. It can even irritate your skin if it touches your skin. So with bugs, it can be an extreme irritant. It can also deter cats from digging in your garden, and dogs. I've used it as a dog deterrent. They get a good whiff of it and they don't like it. So it does not work well with kids, aka warning on that. I mentioned that in a previous video, which I'll put a link in the description. But kids don't recognize that it's hot until after it's too late. And you don't want kids to be touching that oil or that powder or whatever. But if you don't have kids, they can be a great deterrent for animals. They can be a great deterrent for bugs. And you either put it in water and spray it down like you would neem oil, or you dry it up and ground it into a powder and spread it everywhere on the ground, and it can keep the cats and dogs and deer and stuff like that out. So there's a little tip for you. Alright, a little bit on the tips and tricks. Look at these mixy bells. This one back here is so huge. They did really well this year. One of the tips and tricks is, in the beginning, peppers take a while to grow. They have kind of a long growing season. So you want to start these indoors around February, January. And this, again, varies depending on climate. But you want to try and get them started before the frost is done. And then after the frost leaves, make sure the frost leaves. I can't stress how important that is. They do not handle frost well at all. Once it's completely gone and you know for a fact that it's done, then you can start them, and they range between 90 to 100. And there are some varieties that are a little sooner than that, but most of them you're looking at least 100 days, some of them even 150 days before you start seeing fruit. See, we're at the very end of our season, and I'm probably going to pick these and let them ripen in the house, because I'm going to make some jelly for you guys, and that'll be fun. But yeah, not doing too bad. It's going to be a good batch. Some of the problems, like I said, is they don't like to have their roots sit in water. They require a lot of water, but it needs to drain. So you can get blossom end rot. When you grow them in the same spot multiple years, you can get blossom end rot from calcium deficiency. So that seems to be a big issue. As a tip, pinch the flowers off. The first flowers you see, pinch them all off. And that's hard to do, but if you do that, it'll double the production. The plant goes into overdrive and starts just producing flowers all over the place. So that's kind of a tip. Or you can wait until the first couple fruits bloom and then just pick those fruits. It'll both work, but I recommend the flower because you want it to get going quick. So as soon as you see that first flower, that's the time to pick them. And then that kind of like puts it into overdrive nitro, and it like sends flowers all over the place. So anyway, this is Coila Fever with Garden Fever. Please like, share, subscribe, comment. I'll put any information that I missed in the captions, the annotations. Oh, look at those are just so, those will be nice. And then I look forward to my next video where I make some jelly. But please like, share, subscribe, comment. Be more on the way. Thanks for all your support. Thanks to all my subscribers. You guys are awesome. More to come.